I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you the impact test here. Aim to determine the impact strength of a given material using the IZOT test specimen. This is the tableau column which contains the type of test, angle of fall, initial reading, final reading, energy absorbed, impact strength, angle of rise and impact velocity. The observation contains the length of the pendulum are 0.825 meter. In terms of mm, it is 825 mm. Angle of drop is 90 degree because it is IZOT. In case of Charpy, it should be 140. The weight of the pendulum is 21.926 kg. Area of the specimen we have to find out. This is the specimen. We call it the IZOT test specimen. The diagram is drawn here. How to find out the area? This is the area. 10. With the help of the vernier scale, you have to find out 10. And area below the notch. This you have to consider. Area below the notch. That means you have to measure this part. Area below the notch. That means 10 into 7 you will get 70 mm. Is a IZOT test performing over the impact test here. Here the forming hammer has to be fixed. In the Charpy you have to fix the sledging hammer or ball pin hammer. This we call as a forming hammer we have to fix in case of the IZOT test. Next you have to see this inner scale in case of IZOT test. In case of Charpy you have to see the outer scale. One division is contained, 2 joule. It is written here. The maximum energy absorbed for the IZOT will be 168. Now remove the safety lock in order to find out the R1 value. Release it without any specimen over that of the platform. There is no specimen over the platform. Release the lever. Now take down the reading here. The reading is 0. Now the initial R1 is 0 here. Now bring it to the maximum condition. Maximum is 168 for in case of IZOT. You have to see this scale. Now place the specimen over that of the platform by using simply supported instrument. Now we have to place the specimen. The notch should be facing towards that of the, this notch has to be facing towards that of the striking hammer. Now I am placing this part. Now with the help of this simply support you have to fix in this way, and with the help of this Allen key tight it. Now the notch is facing towards that of the hammer. The notch is facing towards that of the hammer. Now here 160 is the maximum. Remove the safety lock. Remove the lever. The obtained value is 32-34. The initial reading will be 0. The final reading is 34. 34 minus 0 will be 34. Now impact strength can be found with the help of this part. Area of the notch will be 10 into 7 is nothing but 70 mm square. U value is 34 divided by 70. Now answer for this is nothing but 0.48 joule per mm square. Now find out this part. U is already known, 34 by 21.926 into R value. R value is 825 plus cos 90. Answer is, this is the answer. Make it cos inverse, shift cos inverse. You will get beta value is 89.89 degree, which is almost equivalent to that of the 90 degree. Now find out the velocity, impact velocity how to find out the impact velocity, divided by root 2 into 9.81 into R value in terms of meter, you have to take meter. That is 0.825 1 minus cos 90. If you calculate, the answer will be 4.02 meter per second. In this way, you have to solve. In this way, you have to solve the Charpy test. Sorry, Izod test. I am Santosh Gangkar. Thank you very much.